Hello everyone, back to the site and landscape series. Now I want to show you how you can create something like this, how you can extrude the edges. So it's not exactly a straightforward process, but what I'm going to do is this. Basically, I want to create another surface, split the surface right next to this, so it's going to show me the pavement surface. Then I'm going to export that surface as a DWG file, and then I'm gonna create a mask and bring the DWG file back to the Revit and deal with it as a mask. Okay, it's a bit complicated, but you're gonna see how it works. So how about I go to the site first? I want to create a surface and split that surface. Okay, so back to masking and site. Split surface, click on the topography once. Now we can select the edges. So basically that part over there is the street. It ends here. And I wanna select this edge. So if you hit tab here, it will select more stuff. And on that side, okay. And I'm gonna keep going, I'm gonna offset, I'm gonna consider if this is gonna be the pavement, maybe it's 1 or 1.2 meters, the width of the paved surface, or even 1.5 or something. And you can click here, you can click here. I'm gonna keep going. Okay, I created the surface. As you see, it's one closed loop around the edges of the street. So I split the surface, you can see it here. Now I want to extrude it a little bit. Let's see, actually I want to hide everything else. So isolate element, okay, there we go. So this is the surface that I want to extrude. Now I want to export this element as a DWG file, so I can work as it as a 3D geometry later. Okay, so file, export, DWG, next, I want to name it as pavement, everything is good, okay, leave the temporary height, yes, okay, better. So now I want to go to masking and site and go to in place mask. Okay, I want to name it as pavement. And now that I'm inside the mask mode, I want to go to insert, import CAD, and bring that pavement file back here. Okay, and the reason it's up there is that if you remember, we change the project base point. So if I move this to level 1 and we change the project base point by 75 meters, so if I go by negative 75, it goes to where it should be. Okay, now you can see that we have the DWG file. Okay, now I want to say that's okay. So finish the mask. I have the mask named as pavement. You can double check the visibility graphics to see if the mask is showing, which it is here. Okay. Now, this is my mask. And if I hit tab, this is the split surface. I want to hide the split surface for now. Okay, now you are only seeing the mass, and you can know from here, right? Okay, now what I want to do is that I want to go to the architecture tab, and I want to deal with this mass as an object that I can create a roof or something based on it. So I want to go to the roof by face. I want to select everything here and create roof. Actually, I also need to change it to a generic type. Okay, and now create roof. There we go. So now this is an extruded surface, right? And I can hide the mask. If you want, you can hide the mask. Okay, this is the roof. Now, maybe I could change it a little bit. I want to duplicate it. I want to name it as pavement. This is going to be our pavement. So I'm gonna consider that the pavement is about 20 meters, or sorry, 10 centimeters, or maybe 15 centimeters above the surface of the road. Let's go with 20, okay? I can also assign a different material to that. Maybe it's concrete or something, or even a tile. Let's go. guessing this. Yeah, let's go with this one. Maybe I would duplicate this as concrete for the pavement, so I can easily follow that later. I'll assign some other color just to be able to know which one it is. Okay, and okay. And it's 0.2, okay, and okay. There we go. Now I want to bring everything back. As you see, it's actually, it has a thickness, but it's inside the ground. So I'm gonna select that, and this is our roof, and the thickness is 20 centimeters. So I wanna move everything 20 centimeters off. Okay, there we go. So now I have the pavement, which is 20 centimeters higher than the elevation of the street. Okay, there we go.